Hello and welcome to today's reflection, Thursday 21st of January. My name's John and I'm a licensed lay minister here in Walton-on-Thames. Today's passage is from 1 Corinthians chapter 7 verses 25 to 40. If you'd like to read the passage, please pause the video now. At the end of chapter 7, as at the beginning, Paul's talking about the subject of marriage and about how it relates to being a follower of Jesus. He's already advised that the situation that you were in when you became a Christian is one in which you're equipped to follow Christ, and that you shouldn't seek to change that situation. But in this part of the chapter, he appears to be saying that if you have a choice, it might be simpler to follow Christ if you're not distracted by becoming married. Now, it's important to note that one of the main reasons he's offering this advice is that in the early days of the church, at the time this letter was written, it was generally thought that Christ would be returning soon, probably within the lifetime of the people to whom the letter was addressed. Preparing for that might be less complicated if you could offer it your full attention. Nearly 2,000 years later, we're in a slightly different situation. We know that Christ might return at any time, but we no longer live in that expectation from day to day. Paul's letters were written to particular churches at particular times and shouldn't necessarily be considered as a book of rules for all time. And yet, taken together and taken individually, they contain some eternal truths. One of those truths is that as the Corinthians did, we live in a time and belong to a church that's operating here on earth, but also seeking to further the kingdom of heaven. We have a foot, if you like, in both camps. Whether single, married, or somewhere in between, our relationships with our families, friends, employers, business partners, and with our possessions too, are relationships that are lived in the light of our relationship with God through Jesus. The way we view those relationships, the way we behave in those relationships, should be in tune with the way that we're called to behave as followers of Jesus. When Paul says, those who have wives should live as if they do not, those who mourn as if they did not, those who are happy as if they were not, that's hard, very hard, to understand. Surely it's not wrong to have emotions of happiness or sadness. Surely it's not wrong to pay attention to your husband or wife. But when he says those who buy something should live as if it were not theirs to keep, those who use the things of the world should live as if not engrossed in them, then it does become a little bit clearer. The things of this world are not forever. The things of heaven are eternal. And the things of this world are certainly not to be clung on to at the expense of the things of heaven. For example, at different times in our lives, we may be married, we may be sad, we may be happy, we may be wealthy, we may be focused on the demands of this world. But none of those situations are necessarily permanent. How we confront, how we work within those situations should in some way reflect that we do so with God's Spirit around us and within. Whatever we're living through today, this week, this month, this year even, is not then a permanent state of affairs, but the love of God is. Whatever we're living through, God's love is with us. Whatever today throws up, whoever we may meet, talk to, work with, live with, we can start by recalling the two great commandments that enable us to walk in this world in the presence of God, to love God and to love our neighbour. If that can be our watchword for today, then I pray that whatever our status may be, single, married, or somewhere in between, we may see God's kingdom advanced in our lives and in the lives of those around us. May you walk today in the light and love of God. Amen.